will not be accessible to us. The only thing that gives us access into the power and the kingdom of God is the blood of Jesus. And so whenever you have the, you get the opportunity to go to the Lord's Supper or to dine with God, you have to know it is a moment of empowerment. It is a moment whereby spiritual keys are being released into your life to have access to divine power and to have access to the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. And because when you have access to the kingdom of God and the power of God, you can overcome the devil. Hallelujah. What the apostle says, the very moment that I heard this voice, all the children of God has access to overcome Satan. Because God's, the plan and the purpose of God was to deliver us from everyone, empty life, vain manner of life, handed down to us by our forefathers. In other words, whatever that we were accustomed to was not helping us. But when Jesus Christ came and shed his blood has got the power to give us life and what? More abundantly. Hallelujah. And so if you want life, then the life that you are seeking for lies in the blood. He said, but with the precious blood, as of a lamb without spot, even the blood of Christ Jesus, that was shed for you and I. Even the blood of Jesus, that was handed down for you and I. And so the blood of Jesus, whenever we apply in our life, it changes the emptiness in us and fills us with divine power. Hallelujah. And I pray that this morning, as we partake of the table of God, that every emptiness in your life, any emptiness in your life, will be rooted out and you'll be filled with divine power, with divine grace, and with divine favor in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
He says there was something that was handed to us that was not benefiting our life. Our society has handed a lot of things to us that is not benefiting us. Our parents did the best that they could, but it was not helping us. But the only thing that will help us for the destiny or the future ahead of us is able to be grounded in the presence of God and covered by the blood of Jesus. Walking boldly, knowing that you will never and you cannot live an empty life, but you will live a fulfilled life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He said, a vain manner of life was handed to us, which means a future without hope, a destiny without fulfillment. But in the blood of the Lamb that came and redeemed us, what he handed us was what? A life of fulfillment. Amen. A future of hope. A life that cannot be what? Looked down upon. But we'll always see the light and the hand of God at work. Amen.
Amen.
And so, if there's something in your life that is empty, then the remedy to overcome or to come out of it is through the blood of the Lamb. And so whenever you are applying the blood of the Lamb, you have to know that you are coming out of every what empty life that was handed to you. I want us to pay attention to this side of this scripture. He said, from every vain manner of life handed down from your fathers. Amen. I want us to go a little bit deep about this verse. Everything. What the Bible is saying over here, that anything that has been transported or anything that has been transferred down to us from our parents, and when the Bible says fathers, it's talking about our generation or the generation that we came out of. That is from our great, 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 great parents. Hallelujah. Whatever that was transformed or transferred to us from that point can be ended through the blood of Jesus. So if negative things were transferred from our forefathers to our generation What the Bible is saying over here, the only thing that can redeem us is the blood of the Lamb. And so as you eat the blood of Jesus and the body today, know that you are a redeemed person, hallelujah, by the blood. And so whatever that it goes on in your father, mother's family, their great parents can never go through in your life. Why? Because you have a new covenant with the blood of Jesus. Something new has been transferred or released into your life. With whatever was already what transferred into your life. Hallelujah. And so you have to know that when you have the opportunity to dine with God, it is not just taking a grape juice, but it's what? It is a spiritual meal that you are taking for empowerment. Hallelujah. It is something that has got the ability, the soul life, and that thou shalt anoint him, that yours and generational curse. He said, anything that carries a generational curse that causes a man to suffer or live in a struggling life, when that person what comes to the blood, know that the thing that is delivering you is not a corruptible what thing. Amen. But it's a blood that has got power, a blood that avenges, a blood that when it comes upon you, it breaks every shackles of the enemy out of your life. Hallelujah. Amen. Let's look at something in Exodus chapter 12 verse 7. One thing that you have to know as you are open, that Satan is doing everything that they can to cause you to lose your faith and your confidence in God and in yourself. Hallelujah. And so God is saying that whatever that I've handed to you is to re-empower you to have faith and confidence in me and in yourself, that you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. Hallelujah. You can do all things through Christ who gives you daily life. Because every day, as you and I are up today, it is God that has given us the life. And if he has given us the light, then we've overcome whatever the enemy planned that it should and could have happened to us. Amen. Are you there? Exodus chapter 12, verse 7.
And they shall take off the blood and put it on two side posts and on the lintel upon the house wherein they shall eat it. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. You see, in the olden days, in the time of Moses, when they were in the land of Egypt, the Bible says that a time came that God wanted to change their custom and deliver them from the land in which they were in. And so God says that, put the blood, mark the doorposts and the windows with the blood, so that it will be a mark of showing that you are a redeemed one, or you are among those that I am about to redeem from the land of Egypt. Amen. But I want us to watch this. In the olden days, they have to apply it on the wall, on the doorpost. But in our days, we apply the blood inside us. Amen. So that the blood will have the power to wash and to cleanse us. Amen. Why we apply the blood for it to stay in us? Because the Bible says we are the temple of God. And so as a living temple, the living temple must carry the blood of the Lamb. Hallelujah. In the olden days, the blood was only in the temple. And so it was the only high priest that can go where the blood is and able to offer what? For forgiveness for the people. But when Jesus Christ came and died, the blood, where the blood saved, is inside us. So he said, as often as you do this, you do it in remembrance of me. In other words, as often as you do it, you do it in remembrance of the redemption that I brought to you. Hallelujah. What we are doing is that we are renewing or reaffirming that covenant that was done by Christ for our life, because we are the carrier of the presence. presence of God, and we are the temple of God, and the blood must always be in the temple and not by the doorpost anymore.
Amen.
So Jesus, the Bible said that when he died and the blood came on the floor, the Bible said, and the what? And the curtains in the temple was torn into two. Hallelujah. In other words, right now, that whatever that covers the presence of God has been changed. We become the carriers of the presence of God. Because in Genesis chapter 1, verse 27, the Bible said, and God created man his own image after his likeness. So we have become what? The God nature moving on this planet Earth. Hallelujah. And so the blood has right now what? Not only is on the post, but right now the blood has come and resident in us, so that what Jesus Christ did will always remain in us and will never be in vain. So, in the Old Testament, they applied on the wall. In the New Testament, we applied inside us. So the application has changed. Amen. Because if it is only one thing, when you read that scripture, that people couldn't move out. They had to stay inside the house. Because it is where the blood is, that is where they will have freedom. Or that is where they will remain what, redeemed. But in our days, when Jesus Christ came and died, because the blood is in us, we can move with the blood and not be afraid of anything. And so the Bible says, although you walk upon snakes and they cannot bite you, you will drink deadly things and it will not kill you. Why? Because the blood is in us and nothing can stand against the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And that is why it says we are carriers of precious wood. Presence of God or precious gifts. And so this morning, as we're done with the Lord, know that your confidence has to be boosted, and know that your faith in God has to be boosted, because God has given you what you need to overcome and to live a fulfilled life. Hallelujah. And so if somebody said you cannot be overcome anything in life, or you cannot become something in life, then you have to look at the face of that person and say, no, do you know something? What the Bible says is that whatever vain life that was given to us by our forefather has been done away because of the blood. And so far as I'm under the blood of Jesus, I have a new life, and whatever you say cannot apply to me, because that is a vain life, and that vain life cannot have influence over me, because it is God that lives in me. The Bible says Christ in me, the hope of glory. Hallelujah. And so Christ is living in you. The Bible says in Leviticus, in chapter 17 verse 11, the Bible said the life of a man is in the blood. And so what we are doing is that whatever life that Christ had is also resident in us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And so you are not just ordinary being on this earth. You are a supernatural being walking among people. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because the Bible says, when you know the truth will set you free. And so the only thing that will set you apart from other people is the level of your understanding and who you are in God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want us to look at something. And so right now, know that the blood is applied in you. And so far as the blood is in you, death cannot come to you. Evil cannot overcome you. Satan, they will put it in food and in water for you. But yes, sir, with Christ in you, you will surely overcome. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's look at something. God doesn't want your soul to live, but the only thing that will help you to live is given to you through the blood. So how you apply the blood will determine how you live. How you value the blood as you partake of it will determine how you live. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I want you to have that knowledge today, that this is not something that an ordinary person is handing to you, but spiritually the angels of God, heaven is handling something to you that has the ability to make your life better.